This feels funny.
Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft on the KingCraft server. Hope everybody's getting into the Christmas spirit. We certainly are here on the server. We got our Christmas tree up and decorated, and we got chests under the tree for people to come and claim so people can give out Christmas presents. And this is LP's tree. He was telling us about his tree. Apparently they dig it up out of the yard, plant it in a little pot, and then replant it back in the yard, let it grow some more, and then do the same thing every year. But right now he's just got a little tree, little potted plant tree. And I never heard of that. We don't do that here in America. Chop down big trees every year like this. If it doesn't touch the ceiling, it doesn't count. But today, I got something I'm pretty excited about. We're going to talk about texture packs. It's been something some of the people have been talking about on the server recently. Some debates have been going on about vanilla versus different texture packs. I think I fall more in the realm of the vanilla textures. I like them a lot. If I do switch out a texture, I try to keep it close to vanilla. And when you play on an SMP server, you can only go so crazy. Because, let's take this sandstone for example. If we switched it out, hold on, rewind. Let's look at this granite for example. Because that's personally a block I'm not going to use very often because I don't like it. So if we were to take that texture and switch it out for something completely different, completely different color, different texture, whatever, it's not gonna look right. You know, granite people use typically with bricks or in like nether themed builds. So when you're messing around with textures, you have to keep that in mind. They still have to fit the original block. So why don't we hop in a creative world and let's check out some textures and just kind of talk about options for blocks, because I'm a huge proponent of sort of building your own pack. And yeah, let's hop into a creative world and talk a little bit about that. Alright, so here we are here in my test world. You may see some of the jungle builds we've worked on out at the base for the villager area. And this is like my block testing area when I'm working on changing out blocks in my texture pack. The base texture pack I use is Faithful 32. It's a 32-bit texture pack. It's pretty popular, I'd say. I think there's quite a few YouTubers that use it. And the reason I use a 32-bit is the blocks just have more texture. And as a builder, I try to add as much texture and detail into a build as I can, and it helps a lot if the blocks themselves have more texture. So let's just look at some of these blocks and talk about why I made the changes I did. The wood types, a lot of them are just the same texture, just recolored. If you look at these three, it's the exact same texture, it's just different colors. So that's why with the birch and the dark oak, I need to go back and look at what packs I actually got all these from, but I just thought it would be interesting to add a little bit more variation between wood types. It looks better to me, and these are usually used in floors, and these are usually used as roofs, so you don't get a whole lot of clash between the two types, I find. And even if you do, I mean, it still looks like a wood texture. And is that one of the new noises? Squeak, squeak. Squeak, squeak. But yeah, I'm still looking for some other cool textures. This is a new texture I've put in here. This is for the jungle planks. I might change it and switch it out for the acacia because I think it's closer to that. But the jungle planks, I never ever used. I've used the acacia a few times. And I like this texture. This is actually from the Biomes of Plenty mod. I think this is the redwood planks. And that's something else. When you're looking at textures, you don't have to just look at texture packs. You can look at mod packs. I highly suggest, you know, just downloading Feed the Beast and just walk around in a modded world. If doesn't matter if you like mods or don't like mods, I highly suggest just checking out different textures. There's just a lot you can see even if you don't like mods. Because there's like I don't even know how many wood options there are in like Feed the Beast, in the forestry pack, in Biomes of Plenty, like I mentioned. There's just so many options. Take this tree, for example. This is in the Biomes of Plenty pack too. Actually, it's not. I took the birch sapling texture from that pack and I custom made the the color for the leaves. It's a little bit off, but I like this kind of yellowy brownish tinge it's got to it. And if you look at a actual birch tree in the fall, the leaves turn this bright yellow color, and I just think it adds a little bit of variation when you're walking through the woods in the forest biome. You get some more color. And speaking of that, if you've looked at the leaves, oak leaves, what else? These two down here, acacia, and well, I've changed the dark oak leaves. They were all the exact same block. Like, you can't tell that apart, but it's two different types of blocks. So that's another really cool opportunity. Like, this is my new dark oak leaf texture. So right now, wasted. There's so many other cool textures you can implement. And as a builder, this is your palette. These are the blocks you get to work with. And if you don't like a block and you're not going to use it, it makes your palette just a little bit smaller. Oh, what is this? Oh, this is... I need to change this back. I was looking at, we don't even talk about that. This is so many options. I've changed the water too to a little bit more of a realistic color. While we're talking about this, I should mention, if you haven't watched Kingy's Game is the name of his YouTube channel. I get a lot of inspiration from him and his builds. This is kind of where I got that idea from, but I had played modded before I started watching his videos and remembered that, and it just made me remember, boy, English, made me remember how much I liked that shade of leaf color. And I like this more realistic water, because the vanilla water, it's nice, but you won't find anywhere in the world just this color water. That's not a thing. And another thing to remember is that you can sort of customize your texture pack to fit your build style, if that makes sense. So I typically use more earth tones, like the grays and the browns and some greens. And you know, if I'm adding color to a build, I'm absolutely bypassing these wools because they're very bright and in your face, and going straight to the wool. Not the wool, the clay colors, because they're all a little bit more muted and they've all got that red tinge to them from the base clay block. So that's something to keep in mind too. Let's look at my new granite texture, because that we talked about that on the server there. This is my new brick texture. It's got more detail to it. I just like it a lot more. If you take this, if you remember Sin's record shop that we looked at spawn, he used some granite and some polished granite and some bricks. Now look at that. Does that not go together better? This is the polished granite block. I went with a brick texture. This is from the Terra Firma Craft. They've got lots of really cool texture packs that give a whole lot of options for stone types and polished stone types. Definitely worth a look. But I thought it would be cool to add another brick texture to it that's got some color on it. Let's just build a little wall segment here. The only thing I don't like about this, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to go back and pick a different one, but I like this color. It's the pattern that repeats in it. You got this white stripe on each block, which I could probably live with it as little as I'll actually see it. But you can come in here with some bricks and take that polished granite. That looks pretty cool to me, and it helps break up this color, but actually it's in this too. So maybe a little bit more brick. Well, that's almost too perfect, but you get the idea. There's just so much you can do with blocks, and it helps expand your palette of blocks you're able to use. And I think that's, as a builder, I think that's, you know, invaluable. But that's all I wanted to talk about today. Like I said, I'm a huge proponent of this. It's kind of a tricky thing because I think overall, especially when you're doing YouTube videos, vanilla is more accessible for people that are watching your videos and trying to, you know, follow along with stuff you're doing. And when you're playing on an SMP server, you have to be conscious of how your textures are going to look on other people's builds. I mean, if it doesn't bother you too bad, I guess that's fine. But yeah, the more blocks you enjoy using and you like looking at, the more options you have. And it's a really cool way to customize your builds and customize your pack to you. So I definitely recommend checking out, you know, stuff like Biomes Aplenty. Forestry has a lot of cool wood plank colors. The logs are kind of weird, but the planks are awesome. Terra Firma Craft has a lot of really cool stone options in some of their texture packs. So check them out, you know, think about it. Especially these leaf textures. Oh, it's getting dark. They're just wasted blocks. It's supposed to look like that. Do something about it, you know? And the skies. I think everyone has these skies by now. I don't know why I've got clouds still turned on. Oh gosh. I'm not even going to bother trying to find it right now. But yeah, check it out. If you find any cool textures that you think might fit in this pack better than stuff I've got or in addition to stuff I've got, hook me up, you know, hook a brother up. And if you got any questions, feel free to ask. But yeah, do it. This is Burrito King signing off from the KingCraft server. Until next time, bye-bye. So I came to spawn to start my episode, and the frames were kind of bad, so I asked the other guys if they had any block lag, and they said, yeah, a little bit, and then Zach said, that might be my fault. apparently he's in the middle of pranking Elf's house. I'm starting to feel bad for Elf, but... I picked up a bunch of eggs and knives in here earlier. Oh, this is bad. This is bad. Look at this. Oh my gosh. You can hardly walk. I'm trying to walk forward right now. Oh. Alright, I'm trying to climb the chicken waterfall.
just spilling down off the first floor into the basement. Come on. These chickens are bullies. Oh my goodness. Whoa. Yep.